What's going on, YouTube? Welcome back to another episode of I Know Chris on the show today, my friends. We're going to be cooking some tilapia fillets on top of the stove in a skillet. Yes, we are. We got two tilapia fillets right here. I'm going to bring y'all in close in a few minutes and let you take a look at them. We're going to put some seasoning on them. We're keeping it very basic today. That's what it's all about. Easy peasy, my friends. How we cooking? Now, a lot of people fry tilapia. Some people bake it. We're just going to put them in a skillet on top of the stove. It's kind of like baking it. It's a lot faster. To me, it is. It doesn't take about 2 to 3 minutes on each side of the tilapia once we get it in the pan. We're going to season it up with some salt and pepper, and we're going to put some Old Bay on it today. I'll show you that in a few minutes. You can season it whatever you want because everybody has a different preference on their taste buds, what they like. But I love Old Bay, and it's really good on seafood, fish, crabs, any of that stuff if you can find it, especially in the United States. I don't know where it's all sold. Maybe sold all around the world, but Old Bay is really good. So we'll sprinkle a little bit on there, put a little bit of butter in the pan, and we're going to put some lemon on this tilapia because I love lemon on my fish. So let me bring y'all in close. Let's season this thing up and get this show going. Y'all stay tuned.
All right, guys. Let's get these two tilapia fillets seasoned up here. Today, like I said, we're going to keep it simple. We got some salt and pepper and some Old Bay. If you can't get Old Bay, you can season it with whatever you like. Some people, you know, may want spices. Some people just might want to go with salt and pepper. Or there may be some other seasoning, seafood seasoning that you like on your fish. But Old Bay is what? Does it for me. So that's what we're going to go with today. And I say two pretty good sized fillets here. We're just going to lightly salt it on each side. I did take these when I thawed them out. I went ahead and wiped them down to get the moisture off them because you kind of want it dry when you put it in the pan. It gets a little bit of a sear on each side. So we're looking for that. Let's sprinkle a little bit of this Old Bay on there. Gives it a nice little color and the flavor is delicious. Old Bay is one of my favorite. You've seen me cook with it before, little country balls. It's just really good stuff. But there we go, that like that. Flip them over. Give them a little dusting on the other side. I like pepper. You may not like as much pepper. Season it till you like it, my friends. Salt will go a little easy on them because we're going to put a little butter in the pan. So, a little bit more Old Bay here. That pepper's making me want to sneeze. Tilapia's not a heavy flavor fish, I would call it. It's not real fishy, and it doesn't have a lot of flavor. So putting salt and pepper on it, and your favorite season, like I said, went with Old Bay, isn't going to hurt nothing. If anything, it's going to enhance this fish. I'm not saying it's a bad fish, but it doesn't have a lot of strong flavor. A lot of fish have a very fishy flavor, and if you don't like that kind of stuff, I'm going to say, why would you eat fish if you don't like fishy flavor? Well, a lot of people like fish, but they don't want it. They'll say, oh, it's very fishy. I hear people say that all the time. Tilapia might be your fish to eat. But like I said, these came up to like room temperature almost. And I mean, not like hot, but I let them sit in the refrigerator for a few minutes after they thawed. And then I wiped them down real good so the seasoning stick on them. We're going to move over to the pan and we're going to put some butter in the pan. Now with butter, you got to be very careful. You don't want to cook on high heat or you will burn it because butter burns. But let's go over to the pan and let's go from there. Y'all stay tuned. All right, guys, we got our pan up on the stove, ladies and gentlemen. Put a little butter in there. That's about a tablespoon of butter, I would say. Go ahead and let that get heating up in the pan. Like I said, you gotta be careful with your butter because you can burn it, my friends, and that won't be tasty at all. Burnt butter is not good. Now, I usually would use a little avocado oil, or there's different kind of high temperature oils you can use. Avocado is very good for high temperature cooking. Olive oil always helps, but like I said, as long as you control your heat, kind of look at your heat, you're going to be all right. You're going to see me doing that off camera. Love me some butter. Delicious. So yeah, we're going to let that get melted in there. And again, in the pan, looking good. And like I said, this is almost like baking a fish, but cooking on your stovetop. I know a lot of people say, what, when I say that? But that's what it's like. And I know a lot of people have gotten into eating more and more tilapia, getting them. It's on the menu more and more in restaurants. So, and a lot of people eat it. They say it's healthy to eat. Some people debate that and say it's not a very healthy fish to eat. So, you know, each his own. I'm not here to tell you what to eat. But I tell you what we're going to do today. That butter's good. We'll get this butter melted down. As soon as it gets melted down, my friends, we're going to pick back up with those tilapias in the pan. Y'all stay tuned. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we got the butter melted. Let's go ahead and get our fillets thrown in there. Like I said, we got this cooking on about medium heat, so you're like, Wayne, this ain't shh. Well, I don't want it to do that. I don't want it to burn because we got butter in here. It's kind of a slow cooking process, but not slow as baking it. Trust me. I know I said baking it is slow, and it is slow. Some people love to bake fish in the oven. I just can't wait that long. I'm impatient when it comes to eating. I get hungry, I'm ready to eat. I know some people, oh, it takes time. Good dishes. Well, that's probably true. But I know Chris does it a whole different way. And if you've been to my show before, you already know this. But there we go. We got them laid in the butter. I'm going to put the lid on like so. That's going to kind of keep the steam. That's going to cook off that fish because it's got moisture in it. And you already see it starting to steam around the glass already. It's fogging up. And that's going to help it. Basically, almost like I said, almost like baking it, but you're steaming it, I guess, in a way. But it's going to look like baked fish, but it's not going to be. But it's going to be so tasty, tasty. So we're going to let this sit here on medium heat. I'm going to do about 3.5 minutes on this side and then 3.5 minutes on the other side. And then we should be good to go. Y'all stay tuned. Coming along, guys. Look at there. Woo! It's going to be some kind of good. I wish I could smell that. Mmm! Smelling good. RC has starting to turn the whiteness. It's starting to come out. You see the pink fading away and there's white on the edges. Won't be long. It'll be time to flip it over. Y'all stay tuned. All right, y'all. There it is. About 2.5 minutes on that side. We're going to give it a little flip. I'm going to try to keep it all together here and not break it. Spatula's not wanting to work with me today. There we go. Oh, I get a little breakage there. Looking good, my friends. Looking good, looking good. You see, it's all nice and white. Ours starting to flake on this side. It's basically done on this side. So we'll get about 2 minutes on the other side, and we're going to plate this thing and eat it on some rice, my friends. Y'all stay tuned. All right, ladies and gentlemen. Booyah. It's time to do it. It's time to do it to it, as I know Chris likes to say. There it is on a bed of rice, my friends, with some lemons on the side. Looking tasty, tasty. Don't y'all think so? Woo, this is going to be so good, y'all. Let me get settled here back to the bar, and let's dig into this and see how good it is, my friends. Y'all stay tuned. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that is it. Easy peasy. Just took a few minutes, 2 minutes to 2.5 minutes on each side. A little bit of butter, about a tablespoon of butter in the skillet on medium-high heat. Put a lid on it. Got beautiful, beautiful dish here. Some lemon wedges on the side. I'm going to drizzle a little lemon juice. I kind of love lemon juice on it. Got a bed of rice up under our fish. Woo, this is going to be good. Also got a beer we're going to pour up, my friends. Now, this is a briny melon goose beer brewed with all natural flavors. It's got a melon flavor to it, but it's kind of salty. And I just tried this. My sister Sandy, she turned me on this, her and her husband Aaron. It's like, hey, check this out. And I think their son Brandon actually introduced them to it. But it's really good stuff. I don't know if you can get it where you live at. My God, it's good. It's got a bear with antlers on his head. Not sure what's going on with that. But we're going to pour that up because I like beer with fish. Almost any seafood, beer is good with. If you like beer. If you don't like beer, then it ain't good with it. Trust me. But that's what we're going to have today with ours. So we'll pour that up right there. Let's get into this fish and give it a little taste, my friends. Now, I want to show you something here. Best I can. It's very, very flaky. I don't know how good you can see that, but my God, y'all. It's delicious. One other thing we want to do, hit with some lemon. Just a little bit of lemon juice. I like lemon on it. I like lemon on all my fish, whether it's fried, baked, however you do it. I love lemon on it. And we just got a little bed of rice up under there. I know Chris going in for a big mouthful. I don't care. It's delicious, y'all. I'm gonna bring y'all something different today. I hope y'all enjoy this. Like I said, it's very flaky. Break right off. That's how you tell it's cooked. Very flaky. 2.5 minutes. My God. Quick and easy dish. You can cook it for a date. Well, maybe not for a date. If you don't want her having fishy breath after you eat, kissy kissy. I know I ain't got no brain. That's the captain trying to come through. But pretty much any time meal for your family, friends. It's so good. And to me, tilapia is a good fish because it's kind of a firm fish. And it's kind of, if you cook a soft fish and you do this, it's going to be mucky and it's going to break all apart. The tilapia, the thin part of the flake, may break apart a little bit like you see me getting out the skillet. But the thick part, it's going to stay together, hold together nicely. It's so good. And on this rice, I'll be like, you don't eat rice. I do eat rice. I love rice. I love rice with a lot of stuff.
brown rice, brown rice, white rice, yellow rice. I don't know if there's any other color of rice. Maybe there is. I'm sorry, I'm eating this in front of y'all. Let's give this beer a little taste here. Oh, it's good. It's got like a kind of like a watermelon or a melon little bite to it. A little bitter bite. And I ain't talking about like a hops. If you know what I'm talking about, beer hops. That's more of a sour to me. But this is kind of like a little like a bitter bite. Something from that would be bitter to you wherever you're at in your country. Maybe like a lime bite. I'll take a little bit like a lime hit. Boom. And the melon flavor or the watermelon or some kind of melon. I taste it going on. And it's briny. You definitely taste the salt in this. And I'll be honest with you, it actually complements this fish very good with this rice. This is so good. Like I said, I'm gonna be bringing y'all different dishes. I know y'all see me cook on the pit barrel all the time. Y'all get sick of that. Especially the same stuff over and over. Some of you may, some of you may not. Leave a comment down below. Another dish I'm gonna be cooking real soon. I'll be coming, y'all look for it. A good friend of mine, subscriber, member, longtime member and supporter, great friend, Beverly Vase, that's her name right here, of her channel, link down below. She told me about Tocino, I believe I'm saying that right. And I looked it up, and my gosh, my mouth started watering just looking at the videos and people cooking it and eating it. Oh, it looks so delicious. So, look for that coming soon. We'll be getting some Tocino pork. What we're going to make it out of. I think some people have made it out of chicken, but we're going to do it out of pork. Gonna marinate it overnight in the fridge and cook it the next day. So look forward to that video coming soon. And if it's a total flop, blame Beverly Vase. She's like, ooh, I'll get you. She's one of them that told me all about it, but man, it looks super good. And I know some of you, especially overseas, have already ate Tocino, and you're probably like, yeah, it's gonna be great. I just hope I don't mess it up, because it could happen. I tell you, I did mess up. This fish, just so good. It's just so good, y'all. It's just so good. Look. That's pretty much gonna wrap this video up, my friend. I won't drag it out no longer than I have to. Look for new content coming very soon. Maybe some more reviews on some alcohol beverages. This is really good. If you can get this, go get it. Loving it. Leave a comment down below. Give me a thumbs up. Thumbs down. If you did like the content, that's perfectly fine. Your opinion counts. Each and every one of you. And hit that subscribe button if you're new here. Check that red subscribe button out. That helps support my channel. There's also a join button if you'd like to join. You can hit the join. There's a level of $1.99 and then there's a $4.99 captain's level. You can join either one or you can join absolutely none of them, and that's perfectly fine with me. I appreciate each and every one of you that come here, whether you're a subscriber or not. I prefer you to be a subscriber, but if you ain't, that's okay. If you're here watching my video, thanks very much. I appreciate it. Appreciate all the support. It's not all about the dollars, my friends. I just love doing YouTube, and I love bringing stuff to people, and they leave comments, hey man, I really love your channel, I love your cooking. It makes me feel good inside. So, I guess that's gonna wrap it up. Until the next time, my friend, you know what to do. Stay safe and keep tubing.